Hello students, myself Muthuraj NP, working as assistant professor in the department of mechanical engineering at Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, Mysuru 2. Heat transfer thermal problem, the problem number 2 that I am going to explain now. The problem statement is like this. Furnace is made up of 3 layers of thickness 250 mm, 100 mm and 150 mm with thermal conductivities of first and third layers are 1.65 and 9.2 watt per meter Kelvin respectively. The inside layer is exposed to the hot gas at 1250 degrees Celsius with convective heat transfer 25 watt per meter square Kelvin, and the inside temperature is 1100 degree Celsius. Outside surface is exposed to the 25 degree Celsius with convective heat transfer coefficient 12 watt per meter square Kelvin. Find the thermal conductivity of the second layer, overall heat transfer coefficient of all the layers and the surface temperatures that you want to find. Let me explain how the problem will run here. Here it is having the three layers. It is having the three layers K1, K2 and K3. Here very important thing is that K1 is given, K2 is not given. At the same time, here HI is given, TI is given. The inside temperature, you make note of this one, inside temperature T1 is given. And then outside H0 and T0 is given. So you can find the heat transfer here. Q is equal to HI A into delta T. What is the your delta T? TI minus T1. If you find this value, then it is very easy you people to find the heat transfer in this equation. Ti T0 divided by R thermal resistance total. In the R thermal resistance, you know Q from this equation. R thermal resistance, you have to find L1 by K1, L2 by K2, L3 by K3. This is supposed to be 1 by HI. This is 1 divided by H0. While A is not there, A value is not given. That's why you want to consider A is equal to 1 meter square. Therefore, you have all the thermal resistance. You put in the total thermal resistance, you have only unknown K2. Then you can find the thermal conductivity K2. And then equate this heat transfer here. Ti, you know, 1250 degree Celsius and 25 degree Celsius. Here if you find all these things, you can find easily K2. Then overall heat transfer coefficient, you can find this from this formula, A into U into Ti minus T0. Otherwise you can find from the equation, U is equal to 1 upon 1 divided by HI plus L1 by K, L2 by K2, L3 by K3 plus 1 upon H0. This is the overall heat transfer coefficient. You can do like this. Very very simple problem. Just observe here how I am going to solve the problem. You have first layer, second layer, third layer. First layer is exposed to the internal heat transfer coefficient HI. This is hot side. Next, external, it is exposed to the cold side. This is T0. This is 25 degree Celsius. This Ti is 1250 degree Celsius. HI, you know, H0, you know, all the things are given. K1, it is given. K2 is not the given that you want to find. This is the thing what you want to do. And then K3, it is given. L1, L2, L3, all these things are converted into the meters. Therefore, you know thermal resistance, how it will come? Ti, T1, T2, T3, T4 and T0 it will come. In between you will have this one, RThI, RTH0, K1, RK2, RK3, RH0 it is given. In some books they are given R1, R2, R3, but you will get confusion with convective heat transfer resistance and then conduction heat transfer resistance. That's why I am taking directly RHI, RH naught for your convenience. You know these values 1 divided by HI, RK1, L1 by K1, L2 by K, L3 by K. A is 1 meter square here. A is, you need not to take, A is 1 meter square, 1 by H0. You can find the R convective resistance, you can find K3, you can find R convective resistance, you can find at outside. This is at in, this is out. Please note down, do the calculation on your own. You don't copy from the videos, calculate on your own. Put the formula and then calculate. And then thermal resistance are given. These are the resistance. You don't know the value of K2 only. K2 only or don't know. Remaining thing you know very well. So all put together, the thermal resistance will be like this. So I have explained convective heat transfer in the first layer. See, in this first layer, you have this first layer, convective heat transfer HI, TI, and here you have T1. In between, you have the heat transfer coefficient with the 25 watt per meter square Kelvin. Put in this formula, you will get the value of Q. You got the value of Q. Put in that formula, you will get the R total thermal resistance. If you find the R thermal resistance equate with this equation, then you will find the value of K2. K2 is 2.817 watt per meter Kelvin. Temperature at intersurface, that you know, 1100 T2, you have to find T2. If at all you put in this equation, then you will find T2 value, you will find 970 degrees Celsius. R thermal resistance due to K2, you will find this one. This is 0.0356 watt per meter Kelvin. RK2 is equal to T2 minus T3. T3 is, you can find from this one, and T4 you can find easily by using these equations. If at all you want to find the value of T4, you multiply this one and then take this side. This is to be this side. Then it will be T4 is equal to, first step, multiply this one, and then after take this side, and then you have to keep here. Therefore, 836.5 minus 0.016 into 3750. Then you are taking minus T4 this side, then it will become plus T4. Overall heat transfer coefficient, already I told the formula. According to that, you have to find the overall heat transfer coefficient is equal to 3.07 watt per meter square Kelvin. Q you have to find, thermal conductivity you have to find. You please note at the end, overall heat transfer coefficient that has these values. Thank you, one and all.